Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Leung. Today I would like to demonstrate an experiment about cellular movement to you all. By doing this experiment, you can recall the basic concept of diffusion and osmosis. In case you do forget the concept, please watch the revision videos again. The chapter of cellular movement is extremely important for many chapters, such as absorption, gaseous exchange in humans and plants, transpiration, nervous system, hormonal system, and human physiology. Enjoy, let's go! First thing we need to do is to remove the eggshell. In order to do that, we put the eggs in a vinegar. Let's start the amazing science journey. The vinegar will dissolve the calcium in the eggshell and expose the differentially permeable membrane. Carbon dioxide is produced during the reaction, so you can see bubbles surrounding the eggshell. The bubbles then will make the egg flow, flip, and turn in the vinegar.
Approximately 10 hours later,
the eggshell is gradually dissolved. You can drink the vinegar and replace it with the fresh vinegar.
4 hours later,
after that, the eggshell will be fully dissolved. The differentially permeable membrane will be completely exposed. Once the step is complete, pour out your vinegar into a sink and gently catch the egg and rinse it. After taking the egg out of the vinegar, you can find it bigger. It's because the water in vinegar has flowed into the egg by osmosis. Meanwhile, the egg becomes more elastic, so it can bounce when you release it to the table. We are not done yet. The next step is to withdraw the water from the egg. We put one egg into the syrup. Remember to gently submerge the egg into the syrup. The egg has to sit in the syrup for 3 days, and you need to check the egg from time to time. Apart from putting the egg into the syrup, we put another egg in the salt. The whole egg is fully covered by the salt. Putting the egg in the syrup and the salt are like making dry food, like salted fish.
Hours later,
after a few hours, there will be liquid founder on the top because the water in the egg has been drawn out. You can pour the liquid out and replace with fresh syrup.
Days later,
let's take out the egg from the salt. The salt becomes a bit wet and stick on the egg surface. Then we compare the size of 3 eggs. The egg in the vinegar is the biggest and the salted egg is the smaller.
Minutes later,
we are not yet done. The next step is to place the salted strivelled egg into the colored solution. Then pour the colored solution to cover the egg completely.
Hours later,
you check that the salted egg becomes bigger and gets colored by the solution. There are 5 eggs in the experiment. The eggs with and without the eggshell, the shorter egg, the egg in the syrup, and the egg in the colored solution. Let's test the texture of the eggs. Surely, the eggshell is hard. The naked egg is swollen and elastic. The shorter egg is less elastic than the egg in the vinegar. The egg in syrup is not only the smallest, but also not elastic at all. The colored egg is also elastic. Let's try to release them from air to the table. No surprise, the normal egg doesn't bounce. The swollen egg without eggshell is very bouncy. It can bounce for several times. The shorter egg is less bouncy than the swollen egg. The egg in syrup is definitely not bouncy anymore. It's very soft and just thick on the table. Finally, the colored egg is bouncy because it also absorbs water from the colored solution. Here comes the challenging question for you all. The colored egg is a bit blue and purple. But how about the inner part of the egg? Share your answer in the comment. Let's start your own science journey. Stay tuned for the next video. Bye bye.